Oh my god, would you just accept the invite?
Mm-mm. No way. This guy's way too cute for me to go on a date with.
What?
I'm sure he sent the invite by accident. Besides, I wouldn't know how to accept it even if I wanted to.
Seriously, stop. You haven't gone on a date in like 3 or 4 months at least.
6.
6 months? You're probably nervous.
This guy could be crazy.
You have all the same interests.
He might be some weirdo with an axe.
He's cute. And he wants to go out with you. And look, he's the same age as you.
He might chop me into little pieces and serve my organs in a pie. It says he's a chef at that new bistro downtown.
Do you actually think someone is crazy enough to chop you into little pieces and serve you in a pie? You don't even have enough meat for a good marinade. Look, I really think you should give it a shot. You always do this.
Do what?
Make up reasons not to date?
I do not.
Yes, you do. You don't want to try anything new because you're always so afraid.
What? Amy, I'm legitimately worried that some stranger from the internet wants to meet with me, probably alone, and I know nothing about him.
Well, earlier you were afraid because he was too cute. I can see that you know I'm right. Just accept the invite and go out with him. You can meet somewhere of your choosing.
In the daytime.
In the daytime.
And what if he's an axe murderer?
Well, then I'll tell all of our friends you were best served with a garnish of pepper.
Great. That makes me feel way more comfortable. Hi, Chris?
Hi, I'm Chris. You must be Tracey.
Yep, that would be me.
Wow, you look just like your photos. I mean, not that I was expecting anybody else. It's just, I mean, usually the girls I meet look pretty different.
Oh.
With these apps these days, you can change yourself to look like anybody. You can change the color of your eyes, the shape of your face. My mom joined this weird website that merges your pictures with celebrity photos. She uploaded the picture of her a cappella group, cropped everybody else out, and merged herself with Kim K. It was weird. I'm sorry, was that too much for the first date? Meeting. Coffee. Coffee date meetup, I mean. I'm sorry, I'm really bad at this.
No, it's fine.
Can we start over? I'm Chris. I bought you a coffee. I'm not sure if you wanted honey, sugar, if you liked it black, so I figured it was a good idea to buy you a cup.
That was a great idea, seeing as we're at a coffee shop.
Did you want to sit down?
Sure. Okay. So, you're a chef?
Yeah.
What's that like?
It's awesome. I've always loved cooking. My grandpa was a cook in a kitchen forever. He taught me and my cousins everything he knew. Visits to my grandparents always started with me running to the kitchen to see what he was cooking. He always saved me something to help him with.
That's really sweet.
Yeah. What about you? What do you do?
I work for a local fashion designer as her marketing person.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's got its perks. I get to try on all of her latest designs and connect her with big names in the industry whenever she's ready to launch for the season.
I've always liked things like that, you know?
Like what?
Clothes. I think wearing clothes is an important part of society. You can really tell what somebody's feeling by, you know, what they're wearing. Take these shoes, for example. You know, did I choose them or did they choose me? You know? I chose them because that's the man I felt like I wanted to show to the world today.
You just read that off, that's fine.
Yeah, I totally did. I'm sorry. My attempt at being connected to fashion has failed.
It's okay. We can stick to coffee for now.
I'd like that.
If I tell you something, do you promise to keep it quiet?
Yes.
Something weird happened with Chris yesterday.
Okay.
We went to his place for the first time and...
That was a really great show. Yeah. I've never seen a musical before.
Well, I'm glad I was the first to introduce you to it. So, are you ready for some horrible, horrible nighttime coffee and some really good jazz?
I love jazz.
Listen, before I open the door, there's something you should know about me.
Oh my god, I'm already scared. Was he married? Divorced. Oh my god, he's got kids.
No. He lives with his mom?
Worse.
Well, I'm a collector. I mean, I have a collection.
Oh,
what? Well, you know, maybe it's just easier if I open the door and show you.
Well, what was it?
See, aren't they great?
What are they?
They're dolls. All hand-painted, well, repainted.
But they're zombies.
Yeah. Zombies painted in full detail.
Do you sell them?
No, I collect them. I thought I told you. See? This one's supposed to be Elvis.
What an interesting collection.
You think? I mean, most girls kind of get creeped out by the whole zombie doll thing.
I would have thought it was about the amount of dolls you have.
Oh, no. It's definitely it's the zombie thing. But I mean, they are a little bit creepy, especially if you're not expecting them, but it's hard to appreciate, you know, all the little details that go into these works of art. Anyway, coffee?
Sure.
All right. That one's for my mom.
No.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's okay. You have so many of them.
Yeah, 300 last time I counted.
You mean there's more?
Yeah, down in the basement. Feel free to go check if you want.
I hope this is when you laugh. I told him I had a marketing project I had to work on. Holy shit. I told you there were weirdos on the internet. You were right. Has he called you?
He's been texting me all day.
Saying what?
He wants to get together tonight.
Well, I mean, you have to invite him over.
What? Why?
Because as weird as, like, doll collecting is, there's, like, a lot of weirder stuff out there.
Well, they're not just dolls. They're zombie dolls.
So he's into horror. A lot of guys are into, like, cult horror.
And are they all collecting dolls?
Probably. Those, like little action figures are a big thing.
I just do not see myself dating someone who collects tiny Elvis zombies.
Well, invite him here, and you can, like, show him your pastime, and then decide if you want to never see him again.
Okay, fine.
Oh. Oh, so good.
Thank you. It's nothing like what you could make, I'm sure.
No, it's great. It's actually awesome meeting somebody else's cooking for a change.
Do you want some more wine?
Yeah, thank you. Listen, I know I must have freaked you out last night, but it's just I really like you and I really want you to know who I am.
Chris, I really like you too. Yes, your kitchen surprised me, but I've realized that we all have things about us that make us unique. You just happen to collect dolls.
listen, I was thinking maybe this coming weekend we could plan another date. I'll cook.
Yeah, that sounds really nice.
So, what do you think about meat pies?
Oh!